I'm here outside St. Mary's Cathedral. This is the doorway here, kind of heading in from the southerly direction. And we'll just notice, now first up, in the center here, this is where the participant would stand, the priest, the mage, etc. Now, what sort of state would they be in as their awareness becomes aware of the light structures around them like this, and being atop the pillar? So if we look carefully at the configuration here, you can see the third eye, three eyes right there with the halo, the extra light, along with the auras around, completely around the body in a way right there. So we're going to enter into the church. Now, as it happens, there happens to be something going on in here. So across the checkered floor we go, and right through, and we can see the priest right here, and there's a lot going on in this church. But let's just note here that we have the Pope right here with in this symbology right here, and this pilgrimage of mercy, and we have the symbolism, further symbolism in the church right here. Chakra. Notice the symbology of the pillars continuing down on here. Notice the symbology of the pillars continuing down on here. Sort of dropping from the ceiling, if you will. And with the priest with the crozier right here, spurning the tree of life, you have the serpent standing on the serpent. The halo of the priest at the rear of the head, the crown chakra. Around here, let's notice that we have this pillar configuration with both the foliage and the kind of structural formation as well, with the cherubim right there. So there would be four cherubim coming out of the pillar. I'm on the corner of College Street and William Street here in Sydney, and this is the Australian Museum here in Sydney, Australia. So I looked at this logo, and as I was passing by, I was just thinking, well, it kind of looks like water in a way, a wavy logo. And as it happens, on this building here, there's another shot of the logo right there, but on this building here, we have that ubiquitous water line up here, symbolized within the building. So I happened to see that as I was passing by around the corner here. I just thought I'd show that. I can certainly show the water line in other places here in Australia and New Zealand, and it will no doubt be around further around the world also. The water line right there once more, and up on the building you will see the water line right there. As it happens, you have the colours of the four main elements right there, but thought I would just show that. Okay, this gets a little bit more interesting as I look around. So we have the sign here, and of course we have the Australian Museum logo right there, but look, here you have now a continuation of that logo with the formation up here, and indeed it's embedded into this configuration here. Now if we look to the building right here, we can see the water line right there, and then if we go higher still, we can see it up here. Also, so interesting to see what is a bit of a confirmation there. Very interesting. Yet a further aspect here is the crystal hall aspect, which is suggestive of the light structure of buildings, in that they are based, the stone is based on light structures. Further up the road here we have the Sydney Grammar School, and indeed there used to be a Masonic lodge in this school. But if we look at the windows right here, and I'll try to pick it up, but going up you have one, two, we're looking at the circles, one, two in the Tree of Life, three, four, five, six, seven. So that would be repeated across on this window also. These windows would perhaps be representative of the participant in the ritual edifice, the participant as the tree also. I am the life, the tree of life, with the orbs on the tree, one, two, three, four, five, six, yes, seven orbs on the tree, strangely enough. The womb, the tree,